Hello, this is Bronwyn Aly, Local Food Systems and Small Farms Educator for University of Illinois Extension. And for this week's Local Food Happenings at DSAC, I want to focus on some new raspberry varieties that we have growing hydroponically here at Dixon Springs, and a little bit more specifically, how we're utilizing materials that we may have on hand to create a couple of different trellising options and looking at those different trellising systems in the hydroponics high tunnel system. We have grown raspberries at Dixon Springs in the past. Those were in in-ground beds in a different high tunnel. And with those, we're looking more at just how raspberries perform in a high tunnel and not really specifically on pruning techniques or trellising techniques. And so now that we're looking at them in a hydroponic system, we wanted to also take a look at a little bit more specifically on some trellising options that we may have within this system. And so that's what we're going to focus on this week. Hope you guys are having a good start to your August. I know here Dixon Springs currently it's cloudy and misting, and we've had rain on and off the last couple of days, and I think we've got it more forecasted for the rest of the week, but looking forward to the hopefully correctly predicted cool spell coming through in the next week or so. With that, I hope you guys have a good week, and check back with us for the next update. Thanks. Another little demonstration project that we have started in the hydroponic tunnel was looking at a couple of different, actually four different raspberry varieties, and focusing a little bit more on some different training options that we might do. Black raspberries happen to be my favorite small fruit, and so I thought we would stick a couple of black raspberry varieties in the tunnel just to see how they perform, as well as, so we have Nuwat, which is actually a primacane bearing black raspberry. And the other variety we have is Bristol. The other two varieties that we have out would be Double Gold, which is kind of a champagne-y blush color when it ripens, and then also Joan Jay. And Joan Jay will be a red raspberry, and the great thing about Joan Jay is that it's thornless. Whereas these black raspberries are very thorny. And so we've had these growing for a while, and now we're looking at some different training options. What you can see right now, we have the strings on the spools just like we do with the cucumbers and tomatoes, and we're running those down and putting a couple clips on the canes that are coming up, and we will kind of train those individual canes up. Once they get so high, we'll tip those, hopefully see some lateral breaks, and then the laterals can set their fruit and hang off of these strings. Ultimately, we're going to create a V-type trellis down each of these rows. So you can see we've started on one side. When we finish, this left-hand side will be angling up towards the center. And we want to hopefully maintain a V-shape trellis system, but we're going to look at a couple of different options for creating that V-shape in this system. We have grown raspberries in a tunnel here at Dixon Springs in the past. It's probably been 7 or 8 years ago, and those were grown in in-ground raised beds, not hydroponically, and they had wire on each side of them to kind of hold them into the row themselves, because raspberries grow very vigorously in a tunnel environment. And so I don't believe in the past, when those in previous work with the raspberries, that we had done any comparisons of different pruning systems. It was more about how did they perform, a variety trial evaluation, and how they performed in the tunnel, which actually worked really well. And there's a lot of information out there on growing raspberries in a high tunnel, mostly more red raspberries. I don't know that we've seen much on black raspberries. So anyway, I just wanted to give you an update on what we're looking at with this little demonstration, and give you another update once we have completed the trellising and kind of show you the comparisons, and we'll be able to show how these brambles are responding to those systems. So it's been a couple weeks or so since I shot the first part of this video talking about our growing and trellising of some raspberries in the hydroponic tunnel, and I just wanted to show you where we were at right now. And so in the last segment I talked about we were going to look at a couple of different trellising options and to try to create a V-shaped pattern or trellis system coming out of these the hydroponic, the Dutch buckets here. And so you can see straight ahead we've created a V-shape. If you note, the canes going up on the right are all clipped to the spooled string, and I had started that in the last video and you saw that, but the left side of these of this particular row was still laying on the ground. The rest of them were laying, canes were on the ground. We hadn't finished the remainder of the trellis. And so what we decided to do for the inside of the canes growing to the inside of these two rows was to create basically another V. And so we wanted to utilize things that we had on hand. And so we had extra metal purlin poles, and we drilled holes in the top of our PVC pipe that drains the effluent from the hydroponic runoff water, drains it out of the tunnel. And so we drilled some holes in the top of that and put the bottom of the posts in there to help support them in their V shape. And then at the top we just use zip ties and attach them together around rebar that we have running through the truss system. So you can see that all the way through. So we're kind of creating a V shape here in the middle. And then we just used tomato twine and tied rows about every 8 to 10 inches apart growing up. And then we have kind of woven these canes on this side and used a couple of clips to attach them to this. This may be a temporary situation as these canes start to produce more laterals and then eventually produce fruit. This string system may not be strong enough to support that, and in which case we have got some high tensile like fence wire, some like 14 gauge wire that we may run through here and eventually replace the tomato twine or string, nylon string, with the 14 gauge wire. We may do that on one side, and then on the other side we do have some woven wire fencing. This is like 4 feet tall, so we may run a couple of rows of that along one side just underneath these canes here to kind of give added support. But we're gonna wait and see how the strings work. It would be really great if we could just utilize materials that we already had on hand that we have been using in other crop production systems. And so you can see we've got the V shape here on this row, and I'll walk around in a minute and show the other row. Also, we have pruned some of the canes back, and so I am trying to get 4 canes growing on each side of the V out of each pot. You can see here, 1, 2, 3, and there's the 4th one on this right side, and We have 1, 2, 3, 4 coming up on the left side. And I will come in and I think I'm gonna strip some of the leaves out close to the bucket and make sure that I've got good airflow into the center, the crown of these plants. And I don't know if you recall from the previous video footage, when we first started clipping these canes up, they were maybe up to this point, you know, maybe about 2.5 to 3 feet tall. And at this point, they are all approaching that 6 foot mark, well over my head. And so I think these are all running at about 6 feet. And similar to the cucumber and tomato system that we've talked about with these clips, as we go up, I am taking a bottom clip off and putting it on the top. And so with our cucumbers, we usually are running about 2 clips. And I think on these right now, I'm going to run 3 clips for now. But I can keep rotating them up as the canes grow. And I did want to show you on this first container, these canes had all been, you know, quite a bit higher. Like this one and this one. And just this morning I came in and started tipping these. And so you can see I've tipped these first 4 canes in this first plot back. And I wanted to show you the difference in this next plot. This cane hasn't been tipped. This cane hasn't. This cane was tipped. It's really hard to focus, I'm sorry. This cane was tipped about 2 weeks ago, or a week and a half or so ago, and I can see 1, 2, 3, I can see 4 laterals starting to break, lateral branches starting to break from that. So that's what we would like to see. And then also show you this one. This one, the tip, as we were putting this cane up, the tip had been busted off of it for quite a while. And the 4 laterals that broke out of that are really long. They're at, you know, we're at probably 2 feet on these now. And so since we have these 4 different varieties, each one of these varieties is got a little bit of a different growth pattern, so we're figuring that out. This new Watt black raspberry is very vigorous, and so gives us lots of cane options to choose from in selecting which ones to trellis and which ones to prune out. Whereas this double gold, it is growing fairly well, but its growth pattern is a little bit different, so we're gonna have to look at that and figure out which canes we want to continue stringing up and how many per bucket we want on this particular variety. I do note that this double cane, or this double crop, I'm sorry, double gold, looks pretty thorny, which it is thorny, but these are more soft. They're a little bit easier to handle somewhat than the thorns on the 2 black raspberry varieties, especially on this tender, on the tender growth. These are, you know, this would be pretty easy to tip barehanded and not hurt your fingers. Now, further down as the cane gets more toughens up, those thorns are getting a little bit stickier. And I'll just kind of go from this angle too, so you can see this direction. So you can see our V in this row. This is our center that we're hoping to be able to walk through or try to maintain some type of walk path. And then here's the second V. And again, trying to get 4 canes on each side. This Bristol variety, not quite as vigorous, I don't believe. as the Newat, but it does throw off some good lateral branches. So that is some of the things that we're looking at this week with the raspberries, and we may give further updates as we look at some different ways that we're continuing to prune and see how they grow in this tunnel situation.